into what we've been waiting for. This is going to be the main event of the evening at stake. Is the WBC Continental Americas Heavyweight Championship. Derek Rossi taking on Carlos Negron. Two big, big heavyweights, Barry. So this is going to be a big power-punching fight. This is Team Negron, Carlos Negron.
Mi nombre es Carlos Negron.
My name is Carlos Negron. I am from Puerto Rico. My camp is in Villalba, Puerto Rico. We did a good training and I am fighting for Real Deal Promotions.
Bueno, Puerto Rico.
Puerto Rico, here I am, Carlos Negron, fighting tonight. I am fighting a great fighter. I trained hard, came here to win. We came here for this belt, for the CMB Continental belt. And I feel real proud and honored to be fighting for Real Deal Promotions.
Carlos Negron, Barrett, and this is a guy, 2005, he represented Puerto Rico in the Pan American Games as a middleweight, and he just kept growing. By the time he got to Beijing in 2008, he was a light heavyweight.
I think a step-up fight for him tonight against Derek Rossi. Rossi falls into that category of tough trial horse. He's been in there with some of the heavyweight division's best, and he's had his moments against some very good fighters. He knocked down Berman Stevenson, or I beg your pardon, Berman Stevenson. I'm gonna get this right, I promise.
Stavern.
Thank you very much, I appreciate it. Anyway, knocked him down. And even Berman didn't remember his first name either. He is 19-1, his only loss was a stoppage. He was stopped in three rounds by another journeyman, Epifiano Mendoza, who had about the same record as Derek Rossi has coming into this fight. So it's a big fight for Negron and very much of a stepping stone fight.
And you know, Victor Vegadao is the guy that's managing him. He did a very smart thing, Barry, because he brought Epifano Mendoza to spar with him and correct those mistakes that he made in that particular fight. I got to see Carlos Negron very early in his career. He did a bunch of fights in Puerto Rico. And then he was a cruiserweight, but everybody kept telling me, no, eventually he's going to be a heavyweight. He's now at 238 pounds.
Big guy, tall guy, he's about 6'5". Very athletic. He'll get all he wants, at least early in the fight, from this guy.
And this is a guy I love. This is Derek Rossi. He's a guy who comes to fight anytime, anywhere, any place. Former defensive end of Boston College, Derek Rossi.
I'm Derek Rossi. I'm going to be fighting tonight on the Evander Holyfield's card. I'm just going to put it all on the line out there because now being signed to Holyfield Real Deal Promotions and having this card being viewed nationwide like this, I think it's putting me on the path of greatness. This opportunity presents itself, and I'm going for it, and I feel more confident and better than ever. I'm pumped and I'm ready. Tonight, it's game on.
Derek Rossi says every fight now is going to be a tough fight, Barry. And for him, he understands that placement, where he is in the ranking, is very important for him to get a real title shot. He is going for a title here, WBC Continental America's Heavyweight Championship. It's a stepping stone.
No question. He's been close. He's had his moments, as we've said, against very good competition. He's been in there with guys just as tough as Carlos Negron. And again, can't emphasize enough, he's had his moments. Now, he hasn't been able to finish the deal. Will tonight be the night?
And you know, there's three losses in a row were all ones that, again, could have gone either way. Had to go a long ways, went to all the way to Germany to take on Erkan Temper. Big 6'8" guy, you know, and those are the kind of things that it's tough when you got to go on the road. There's the WBC Fekkerbox title in the possession of Carlos Negron. And then we'll see. Now, tonight, CBS Sports Spectacular is presented in part by Kentucky Department of Tourism. If you need weekend plans, visit KentuckyTourism.com. I'd like to thank Kentucky Governor Mevin, Louisville Mayor Greg Fisher, Jason Rittenberry, the president and CEO of Kentucky Venues, for being the most gracious host of all. So now, let's go to David Diamante.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, good evening and welcome to Freedom Hall here in Louisville, Kentucky, USA, for Evander Holyfield's inaugural Real Deal Championship Boxing Series. It's time for the featured bout of the evening. And it's all being brought to you courtesy of Real Deal Sports and Entertainment, Louisville's TKO Boxing, Kentucky Venues, and CBS Sports Network. Sponsored by Venom, 4th Street Live, Downtown Louisville Marriott, Kentucky Tourism, Winton and Heastan Law Group, and Diamante's Brooklyn Cigar Lounge. Special thanks to the Louisville Sports Commission and Argy Financial Group. This bout is sanctioned by the Kentucky Boxing and Wrestling Commission, Chairman Chad Miller, and the WBC. President Mauricio Suleiman, Supervisor Ringside, Jill Diamond. Introducing your three judges scoring this contest from ringside. Amy Evans, Kent Hendrickson, and Tony Hopper. At the sound of the bell, your third man in the ring will be Martin Whittemore. And now, ladies and gentlemen, 10 rounds of boxing scheduled for the vacant WBC Continental America's Heavyweight Championship. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, he wears the black and silver trim. He weighed in at an even 238 pounds. His professional record, 19 victories against one defeat. He has 15 wins coming by way of knockout. From San Juan, Puerto Rico, ladies and gentlemen, the 2008 Olympian and current CMP Figure Box champion, please welcome Carlos El Olímpico Negrón. And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the red corner. He wears black with gold trim. He weighed in at a ready 231 pounds. His professional record, 31 victories against 12 defeats. He has 15 wins coming by way of knockout. From Medford, New York, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Derek El Leon Rossi. Rossi.
Others receive the instructions, obey the commands at all times, protect yourself at all times. Watch the headbutts, watch the rabbit punch. Any questions here? Question here? Chief Second, touch him up, God bless.
The final instructions by referee Marvin Whittemore. And again, two titles are going to be at stake here, the Fecker Box and the Continental America's Heavyweight Champions, the WBC version of it. Your principals in the ring, they are Derek Rossi. He's going to be wearing the black trunks and the gold belt and trim. The much taller Carlos Negron, 6'6" tall. He is going to be wearing the black trunks. You'll see the Puerto Rican flag. Negron born in Villalba, Puerto Rico. Part of a police family, all his brothers, father, everybody in the police force of Puerto Rico. Derek Rossi from Medford, New York, a man who has totally redefined his body after playing defensive end at Boston College and weighing 278 pounds. He's now at 235, Barry.
Yeah, very interesting guy, too. Very smart guy. Really kind of gets it. He says, just have fun doing it. You never know what's going to happen. And as we said, he has had his moments. Early part of this fight, you got to keep an eye on Rossi.
And for there, Carlos Negron saying what he's going to have to do is keep his hands high, and then when he has his chance, he's going to come in, especially his left hook to the body. Rossi has been against, you mentioned some of those guys, Bernard Stiverne. He's been in against some excellent fighter. And he's adept at fighting guys much bigger than him. In fact, his last opponent, 362.5 pounds. And he knocked him out in the second round, Richard Carmack.
Yeah, he's been able to beat the journeyman guys. It's only when he's stepped up. A little right hand from Rossi, a pretty good one. And Rossi gonna jump right on him here. Another left hand from Rossi. That sends him into the ropes.
And again, remember, in the first round is when he drops Stiverne, but it was right before the round, and Stiverne recovered from that. Rossi doing a good job and kind of planting a trap for Negron. Negron started to throw that left, and that's when Rossi came over that with a right hand. And there's a reach advantage. 83 inch for Negron, 76.5 for Rossi. Let's so far that Rossi right hand Barry's found a home.
Yeah, doing a good job of the body of Negron, and likewise, Negron doing a pretty good job of the body of Rossi.
Now, what Negron has to avoid here, Barry, and see if you see the same thing here, is to lean. He has a habit of leaning towards Rossi, and that's where he's in danger.
Yeah, Rossi's the kind of guy that will make him pay for that.
When I asked Negron what he knew about Rossi, he said, well, he's very slow, very slow. The final seconds of this opening round. Scheduled for 10 rounder at stake. WBC Continental Americas and the Pecker Box title. Round number one in the books. And that's gotta be, for me, it's a Derek Rossi round.
Yeah, I think so too.
It looked like Carlos Negron wanted to do some damage, and it surprised him right off the bat when he teed off with that left hand, and there was Rossi answering with that straight right hand.
Rossi definitely has some pop. There's no question about that.
Take it here, Barry.
Here it is, and you'll see Negron, and you talked about this. He reaches a little bit, and over the top comes Rossi. That got his attention. There was another left hand that got his attention as well. There it is.
You know, when you look at a guy 6'6", Barry, what do you see in front of you? A lot of body. A lot of body to attack, and let's see if Derek Rossi does that, is find that body. Work the body. Then you see Luis Bocachica, the trainer for Carlos Negron. I saw Negron as a cruiserweight. He was devastated.
Yeah, I'm surprised. You were saying he started as a middleweight, fought as a middleweight as an amateur.
Yep. And he just kept going. There's guys like that. I grew up with a guy named Mark Chrisman. Same thing. 5'9 as a senior. Now he's 6'6". Was a shortstop and then grew out of it.
I was 5'8 as a senior. Now I'm 5'7".
Yeah, but you carry a weight. You carry it well, though.
I've been worn down.
Round number two of a scheduled 10 rounder. It is for the WBC, Fecker Box and Continental America's Heavyweight Championship. Derek Rossi. And the much taller Carlos Negron of Villalba, Puerto Rico. Rossi from Medford, New York. You know, there's a guy who just loves the physicality of the sport. I mean, he's a Boston College graduate.
Yeah, very smart guy, as we said. I mean, he could go teach. He wants to teach when the boxing thing is over. But he said, I'm just having fun. I'm going to do it as long as I'm having fun with it.
Loves the training. Trained by his father, Carlos Rossi. Also, Grant Jellickson.
Yeah, his father told us that he tried to dissuade Rossi from becoming a boxer by waking him up at 10 o'clock at night, right after he fell asleep, to go out and do road work. And Rossi said that's what made him love it.
Some guys love it. Good right hand by Negron. And Rossi now fighting back. Yeah, I think he was hurt momentarily.
I think he's still hurt.
Sensing that now, trying to plant that, and that's what he says. I'm going to keep my hands high, and when I get a chance, I'm going to pop him. Derek has used this technique of fighting, and when he fought Eddie Chamber, that was one of the things that he did. He ended up changing his style for the second time, and he ended up fighting from the rope, kind of his own version of the rope-a-dope, after losing badly in the first time when Eddie Chamber just outboxed him.
That's a slip. I think that's a slip.
He's going to call that a knockdown.
Boy, it sure looked like he fell over.
Looked like they stepped on each other's feet. First knockdown of the fight.
Well, we'll be able to see, I hope.
And Derek's got to get some movement here. Some movement, start throwing some punches. That's one of the things, you know, you train for a tall fighter, but I tell you what, it's a different inside that ring when all of a sudden you realize the speed and the reach and the way he manages it. Right now, Derek's not snapping those punches very quick. Negron, his confidence has got to be rising here after knocking down Rossi. So I think this is going to be a 10-8 round for Negron.
So we'll see. I don't know. I know their legs tangled up. Maybe there was a punch. If there was, I didn't see it.
Derek Rossi will come back to his corner. This is Luis Bocachica in the ear of Carlos Negron. And he's doing exactly what he's always going to do. He's going to keep his hands up high and then take a shot when he has the opportunity to present stuff. He's going to unload. Here, take it from here.
All right, we'll see. Prior to the knockdown, Negron was there with a couple of good shots. Nice right hand right there. And that did wobble him a little bit. But now let's see what happens. Missed with that, and then a right hand by Rossi misses. And just about 20 seconds later, let's see what happened. I did not see the punch.
You see the stepping of the foot?
Yes.
We get a shot from our camera guys. You might be able to see that. But this is his father, Carlos Rossi, talking to him. And Derek is breathing very hard. Round number three of a scheduled 10-rounder. These are the big boys, the heavyweight division, fighting for the WBC Continental and Fekabox. Continental America's and Fekabox Heavyweight Championship. In the second round, referee Marvin Whittemore declares a knockdown. So that's going to be scored as a 10-8 round, I'm assuming, on the part in favor of Carlos Negron, the much taller fighter. Now really loading up on those shots here.
Yeah, actually, Rossi hit him a moment ago with the right hand, and Negron didn't go anywhere. Real confidence builder for Negron.
You know, heavyweight, their maturity, they probably reached the full maturity at 27, 28. I think Negron is reaching that at 29, up to 238 pounds, and is carrying it well. Trying to throw some uppercuts is Carlos Negron. Now that's the kind of punches Rossi needs, that sharp jab, Barry.
Yeah, he's not offering much right now.
In Rossi's corner, they're urging him to just relax. And you see blood now coming from the nose of Rossi. And that's going to be, the problem with that is going to be breathing. He's going to have to open that mouth. Bottom line, Barry, it's a tough way to make a living.
Sure is.
I got the utmost respect for anybody willing to come through those ropes.
And we asked him when we talked to Rossi, we said, why do you do this? You don't have to do this. He said, I just like it.
And I think, you know, at the stage that he is in his career, he'd love an opportunity.
He's in trouble again.
Negron, the confidence surges. Referee Marvin Whittemore getting Rossi, who's tangled up in the ropes. Rossi, who often goes to this rope-a-dope style of fighting. And I think this is the kind of thing that hurts him in the scoring, Barry.
Yeah, he lets the other guy dictate the tempo of the fight, dictate boxing position.
Now the key is going to be, how is Carlos Negron able to carry that 238 pounds for 10 whole rounds? Negron saying that didn't hurt me. You know, the way Negron is focusing his eyes on Rossi, and now the blood is coming from now not just the nose, and it's getting wiped out towards the eye. Final seconds. We'll be back with more right after this.
Whatever it is that makes your business great, promote it with Vistaprint. Choose from banners, postcards, or business cards, each starting at less than $10 when you enter TV10 at Vistaprint.com.
Welcome to Stouffer's Fit Kitchen. Prime cuts of meat, 25 grams of protein, and savory mouth-watering sides. It's the perfect balance of delicious and nutritious, making it just the right fit for you. Stouffer's Fit Kitchen Meals. This is fit.
Remember when taking a bath and going for a swim became the same thing for a few days? Then keep the tradition going at Bass Pro Shops Family Summer Camp. Plus, check out huge savings for summer fun during our Star Spangled Summer Sale.
Real Deal Championship Boxing from Freedom Hall in Louisville, Kentucky, and this is one heck of a fight. The nose of Derrick Rossi really was bleeding in that third round, and we'll see if Negron goes to work on it again.
I thought Rossi was in a little bit of trouble at the end of that round.
In his corner, they're urging Rossi to go ahead and just relax, relax. But it's tough when you've got a guy that's got a reach advantage of you, 6-inch reach advantage. Goes in favor of Negron. And Negron can punch. Now Negron switching to a southpaw. I haven't seen him do that before.
A jab, actually, back Rossi back here.
No, he's a strong guy, Barry, but my question is going to be, can he carry that 238 pounds for 10 whole rounds?
And that's a very good question. I mean, this guy has fought eight total rounds in 6 years. Total.
He didn't fight at all in 2014. He had only one fight in 2012. The nose again of Rossi bleeding. Negron, you can just tell, Barry, by that look in his eye that he is just, he doesn't feel Rossi can hurt him.
I think he's taking Rossi's best.
In the corner, Rossi, they're urging him to throw the right.
Down on his own accord.
I wonder if the nose is really a problem.
Could be. I think that you make a very good point.
Yeah, that nose is, look at him. He's not even defending him, so I think they should stop this. That's it.
Well stopped.
Marvin Whittemore, the referee, steps in. And Victor Vega's fighter, Carlos Negron, showing us that at 238 pounds, then you see a father-son team right there. Two class guys, Carlos Rossi, his son Derrick Rossi, Carlos Negron from Villalba, Puerto Rico, all his brothers, five brothers, all fighters. And he definitely showed us the 238 pounds, Barry, he's a force.
Yeah, I think he is. This is a nice step forward for him. He did what he had to do. He handled a guy who's a known tough guy. And he handled him pretty well. I thought Rossi had his moments in the first round, and after that, Negron just kind of took over the fight. And again, we keep talking about what this series is about, really, is stepping stones. And that's what this guy took tonight.
And Carlos Negron has a three-fight deal with Evander Holyfield's Real Deal Sports and Entertainment. And we'll see you again in another Real Deal Championship Series, boxing series. Carlos Negron. Good job by his trainer, Luis Bocachica, who did a great job preparing him. And a lot of it, they did a good job in putting that 238 pounds. And here's some of the action towards the end.
Here's the knockdown. And there was a punch there, but you could see that Rossi, I think he was hurt. Something happened. You mentioned the nose could well have been. Saw him kind of rubbing on his cheek as well.
And by then, he wasn't answering. He didn't throw anything, tried to throw one back. And Marvin Whittemore steps in there.
Well stopped, I thought, by Whittemore.
So we'll see now. We'll get the official. We'll get the official time of the knockdown. When you get a chance, let's take a break. We'll be back with more, and we'll get the official time of the knockdown.
Long live the courageous. The tenacious, the ones who push forward and give back. Long live the greater good, the helping hand, and long live the truck built to outlast them all. Ram, America's longest lasting pickups.
Now get an average $11,468 in total values or 0% financing on the 2017 Ram 1500 Bighorn Crew Cab.
Come on, please miss this. Please miss this. Down to a
free throw. There you go, guys.
What is this?
That's a food udon. You know, it's a big shot.
Food udon.
All right, yeah. Okay, got his arm.
Oh, no. It's a miss, but, oh, man.
Put it back. Put it back.
What is that? His hip? His pelvis?
I'm just trying to.
Well, then at least needs to be symmetrical.
We could have a bit of a delay, but we'll get back with overtime.
No.
Introducing the easiest way to get Gillette blades.
Text blades to Gillette on demand.
Text to reorder blades with Gillette on demand and get $3 off your first order.
Introducing the new Sleep Number 360 Smart Bed. The only bed smart enough to change sleep as we know it. It senses your every move and automatically adjusts on both sides to keep you comfortable. And snoring? Does your bed do that? Right now, save on Sleep Number 360 Smart Beds. Plus, it's the lowest prices of the season with savings of $500 on a most popular P5 bed.
Remember when your first tackle box seemed like your very own treasure chest? And keep the tradition going at Bass Pro Shops with great deals like Redhead Men's Whitewater Shorts for under $18, plus free family activities and crafts.
Welcome to Stouffer's Fit Kitchen. Prime cuts of meat, 25 grams of protein, and savory mouth-watering sides. It's the perfect balance of delicious and nutritious, making it just the right fit for you. Stouffer's Fit Kitchen Meals. This is fit.
We know who made that hitch. We know who cut the steel, who milled the ball, and who welded the seams. We know who tested, measured, and checked. We even know who thought the whole thing up. We're B&W, and we know your hitch. Because we don't make them halfway around the world. We make them all right here. B&W. Trusted.
And Carlos Negron puts on a spectacular performance. And now let's get the official time of the knockdown from David Diamante.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Marvin Whittemore calls a halt to this contest. The official time of the stoppage, 1 minute and 55 seconds of round number four. Your winner by TKO and the new WBC Continental America's Heavyweight Champion, Carlos El Olimpico Negron.
And there you see a very happy Carlos Negron. The official time, 1 minute, 55 seconds. Rossi, again, showing tremendous class as we expect of him. And for Negron, a tremendous win, Barry, because he took out one of the top contenders in the world.
Yeah, I think very much of a stepping stone, as you said, for Carlos Negron. I think he now is ready to take that next step and fight. I'm not trying to say that Rossi wasn't a live body, but when I refer to live body, I mean somebody who's got a similar record to him, and let's see what he's really made of.
So that's Carlos Negron, the new WBC Continental America's and Fighter Box Champion, Heavyweight Champion. We'll be back with more bonus coverage coming up.